गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन. दिस इज अ वीडियो फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8, सब्जेक्ट साइंस. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 14, दैट इज केमिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. This is your lecture number 1. Topics to be covered in this lecture are, first is conductivity of solids, and we will do some activities to check whether the given material is conductive in nature or not. Okay, and next is conductivity of liquids. So we will cover these two topics in this lecture. So students, let us first learn about some important terms used to describe chemical effects of electric current. We have learned earlier classes that some material allow electricity to pass through them, while some do not allow electricity to pass through them, right? We have already learned in the previous classes. Now, on the basis of this, the materials are divided into two categories. First is conductor. Now, what are conductors? The materials which allow electricity to pass through them are called conductors. It means, if electricity can pass through the material, then that materials are called conductors. Okay, if electric current pass through the material, then that material is called conductor. For example, all metals are conductors. It means, electricity can pass through all metals. Okay, for example, we know that electricity can pass through wires, right? And the wires is made up of metals like aluminium, copper. So electric wire is an example of conductor, or we can say the all metals are conductors. Okay, on the other hand, the material which do not allow electricity to pass through them are called insulators. Okay, means if the electricity do not pass through the material, then that material is called insulator. For example, rubber, plastics and glass. These materials do not allow electricity to pass through them. Like if you want to pass electricity through these material, then electricity cannot pass through these materials. And these are called insulator. It means the material which do not allow electricity, that are called insulator. Okay, electricity cannot pass through them. Like rubber, plastic, glass. Okay, so students, now the question is, how can we check whether the given materials are conductor or insulator? So students, in class 6 we made a tester to test whether a particular material allows the electric current to pass through it or not. So now we will recall how the tester helped us in deciding that whether the given material is conductor or insulator. We found that metals such as copper, aluminium conduct electricity, whereas materials such as rubber, plastic and wood do not conduct electricity. So students, now we will perform an activity to check whether the given materials are insulators or conductors. And for doing the activity, the materials required are: take a screwdriver, two copper wires, a cell and a bulb. Okay, and make a circuit as shown in this picture. This is a cell whose one end is connected to bulb and the other end of the cell is connected to the metal part of the screwdriver. And here you can see that this wire is also connected to the metal part of the screwdriver. So what happened in this case? Does the bulb glows when connected to metallic part of screwdriver? Does the bulb glows? So you will observe that the bulb glows when the wires are connected to the metal part of the screwdriver. Okay, means bulb glows. But why the bulb glows when the wires are connected to the metal part of the screwdriver? Because metals are good conductor of electricity. Okay, it allows the electricity to pass through them. So this shows that all metals are good conductor of electricity. Okay, so by doing this activity, we have observed that metals are good conductor of electricity. So if we consider the another case, suppose now we are connecting the ends of the wires to the plastic handle of the screwdriver. So what happened in this case? Does the bulb glow when the wires are connected to the plastic handle of screwdriver? No, bulb does not glow. Why? Because plastic is an insulator. This shows that plastic is an insulator, because on connecting the wires with the plastic handle of screwdriver, the bulb does not glow. This shows plastic is an insulator. So in this way, we can find out that whether the given material are insulators or conductors. Okay. So students, result of our activity is, we have observed that in case of metals, bulb glows. That's why they are called conductors. Metals are conductors. And in case of plastic, bulb does not glow and plastics are insulators. So this is the result of our activity. So students, other than solids, liquids can also conduct electricity. Okay, so now we will learn about the conductivity of liquids. Okay, so students, water that contain impurities such as salts, minerals can conduct electricity. Means if the water contain impurities, then that water can conduct electricity. For example, tap water. Tap water contain many impurities. It means tap water can conduct electricity. Sea water can also conduct electricity. River, lake and ponds water can also conduct electricity. Means water that contain impurities can conduct electricity. And the liquids like lime juice, salt solutions are also good conductors of electricity. Means liquids like lime juice and salt solution can also conduct electricity. Means electricity can pass through these liquids. Okay, electricity can pass through these liquids. So students, now we will do an activity. Activity number 2, to show that tap water conducts electricity. aim of our activity is to show that tap water conducts electricity. And for doing this activity, the materials required are battery, bulb, and wires. Means take a battery, bulb, and some wires and make a electric circuit. Before making the circuit, you should know the symbol of some materials that are used in electric circuit. Wire is represented by a straight line. It can be horizontal line or vertical line. Okay, and the bulb represented by this symbol. This is a symbol of bulb. This shows a bulb. Okay, and battery is represented by this symbol. This is a symbol of battery. And we know there are two terminals in a battery, positive terminal and negative terminal. This longer line represents positive terminal of the battery, and this shorter line represented the negative terminal of the battery. Battery is a combination of cells, okay? And battery is represented by this symbol. Now, we will make an electric circuit, okay? First of all, consider a battery. This is the positive end of the battery and this is the negative end of the battery. Now, join the negative end of the battery with a bulb. Okay? And connect the other end of the battery, means the positive terminal of the battery, with a wire. This straight line shows a wire. Means the positive terminal of the battery is connected with a wire. Similarly, connect the other end of the bulb with another wire. Okay? Like this. And then take a beaker which is filled with tap water. Suppose this beaker is filled with tap water. And dip the free ends of the wire. These are the free ends of the wire. Now, dip these free ends of the wire into tap water. Like this. But remember one thing. Take care that the ends are not more than 1 centimeter apart. Okay? And they do not touch each other. So, when you dip the wires into tap water, does bulb glows? Means on dipping the free ends of the wire into tap water, does bulb glows? Can electric current pass through them? So, the answer is bulb glows. Means you will see that the bulb glows. Why? Because tap water allow the electric current to pass through them. Okay. If tap water allow the electric current to pass through them, so when the bulb receives the electric current, then it glows. Okay. Bulb glows on receiving the electric current. It means it shows tap water also conduct electricity. Tap water allows current to pass through them. Okay, so from this activity we have proved that the tap water conducts electricity. And if you take lemon juice in place of tap water, then on taking lemon juice the bulb also glows. Okay, on taking lemon juice also bulb glows. It means what? The lemon juice also conducts electricity. So The water which contain impurities can conduct electricity. Okay, like tap water, pond water, river water, they contain impurities such as salts and minerals. So they are good conductor of electricity. But the distilled water or pure water, which are free from impurities, cannot conduct electricity. Okay? So the result is tap water can conduct electricity. Distilled water or pure water does not contain any impurity. That's why they cannot conduct electricity. So students, this is your homework. Question number 1 is multiple choice question. A part is, which of the following does not conduct electricity? Options are rubber, lemon juice, distilled water, all of these. B part is, which of the following conduct electricity? Options are tap water, lemon juice, distilled water, all of these. Question number 2 is, fill in the blanks. A part is, metals are dash conductors of electricity. B part is, dash water is free of salts and impurities. Third question is, true or false? You have to mention whether these statements are true or false. A part is, rubber is a good conductor of electricity. Second part is, lemon juice is a poor conductor of electricity. And the last is, impurities in water increase its conductivity. Question number 4 is, give 2 examples of good conductors of electricity. Question number 5 is distilled water a good conductor of electricity? Right, yes or no? So these are 5 questions you have to do in your FAIR notebook today. So this ends for today's lecture. Thank you.